और पता है ना 10 साल हो जाए, बृहत भागवता मृतम, भागवत भी बृहत है, उसका जो सार है उन्होंने करके सार स्वरूप में उन्होंने बृहत भागवत मृतम लिखे, मतलब बहुत कम समय में उसको जल्दी जल्दी पता चल जाए सार क्या है और अपना जीवन में अपना है।
So he's describing that how Srimad Bhagavatam is considered to be the essence of all the Vedas, of all the Brahma, etc. is considered to be the essence. And it's also described that whoever will read the Srimad Bhagavatam, he will be able to easily be able to attain the nectar or be able to absorb himself in the topmost devotional activity. Now the question arises and his mind will become absorbed in the law. And it is that if this Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all the scriptures, and a question may arise here that why did he have to write this, Sanatana Goswami Pada had to write this scripture, Brihad Bhagavatam subject, when somebody reading this scripture can cross over this ocean of material existence and it is the essence of all the scriptures, then why did he have to write this Brihad Bhagavatam here? Because just like I described earlier, that will come a time when the human's life will, span will become just about 10 years and how many shlokas? There are 18,000 shlokas in Srimad Bhagavatam. So he knew that will come a time when the lifespan of the living entities in the humans will be very short. So because he knew this, so he is very merciful, he is very kind and towards all the human beings, and he wants that they should anyway, even if they have a short lifespan, then also they should be able to understand their goal very quickly. So that they will be able to understand their goal very quickly. That's why he wrote this Brihad Bhagavatam. It means it is the, although this is the essence of all the scriptures, but this is the nectar from the essence of those scriptures. This Brihad Bhagavatam.
This is the nectar of Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is also the essence of all scriptures, but this Brihad Bhagavatam is the Srimad Bhagavatam, essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. This Grantha. यहाँ पर कहते हैं कि ये फिर इनके हृदय में स्फूर्ति जैसे होंगे, प्रश्न करते हैं सनातन गोस्वामी के हृदय में ये ग्रंथ स्फूर्ति कैसे हुई है, कहते ये महाप्रभु का आशीर्वाद से, केवल महाप्रभु कृपा से ही ये इनके हृदय में ये स्फूर्ति प्राप्त हुई है, ये महाप्रभु का आदेश से उनके ग्रंथ में लिखे है, हैं महाप्रभु कृपा से। बोले महाप्रभु कृपा कब हुई, कहते महाप्रभु ने इनको सनातन शिक्षा, एक सनातन शिक्षा है महाप्रभु ने इनके हृदय कुलते ब्रह्म हृदय जो आदि कवे, जैसे श्रीमद् भागवत ग्रंथ को सर्वप्रथम भगवान ब्रह्मा जी के हृदय में स्फूर्ति प्राप्त कराया, कहते उसी तरह श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु ने श्री सनातन गोस्वामी के हृदय में उन्होंने ये सारे सनातन शिक्षा माध्यम से उन्होंने स्फूर्ति प्राप्त कराया। ये महाप्रभु का आशीर्वाद से ही ये भागवत का सार दुनिया में कोई नहीं लिख सकते, कहते अपने सारे शास्त्र को मंथन कर उन्होंने
So somebody may ask this question that how were they inspired or what made him
write this? They are telling this scripture is the among the all scripture. And this is the topmost scripture of the all scripture. And then it's come to ask this question, how did the manifest of this happen?
Yeah, how did this manifest and how did how were they inspired to write this scripture? So it is described that just like the Lord, He inspired in the heart of Brahmaji with few shlokas and then He was able to expand into the entire Srimad Bhagavatam. Similarly, this was inspired or given spurti, given the realization of all this in the heart of Sanatana Goswami Pada by the teachings of Sanatana Shiksha. There is one part of Chaitanya Charitamrita which is known as Sanatana Shiksha. Through this Sanatana Shiksha, he inspired or imbibed these teachings, this beautiful spurti to his heart, and he was inspired to write this. This is by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because he wanted to give benefit to the living entities of Kaliyu. That's why he inspired through the heart of Sanatana Goswami
Pada. Bala Sachikandana Gaur Hari
Ki Jai.
देखा है शुरू शुरू में बता रहे हैं कि उत्तरा पूछ रही है परीक्षित महाराज अपने बेटे से, अपने
अपने बेटे से
तो
बोल रहे हैं कि अगर उनसे पूछ रही हैं तो घर गावदान तो तब आई, तो अभी तो नहीं आई, तो महाप्रभु के थ्रू तो नहीं आई, ये कुछ सवाल पूछ
अभी तक
मतलब अभी तो 500 साल पहले ही अभी आई महाप्रभु तो, लेकिन ये तो वो तो बात कर रहे हैं उत्तराखंड, इसका मतलब ब्रज भागवत अमृत तो तभी से आ गई थी जब उत्तरा ने पूछा था ये सवाल परीक्षा।
वो तो उसी समय का ग्रंथ है, समय उसी समय का लेकिन यहाँ पर श्री सनातन गोस्वामी ये खुद बोल रहे हैं, कहते सनातन गोस्वामी खुद बोल रहे हैं, इनके हृदय से ये स्फूर्ति कैसे होगी, कहते महाप्रभु कृपा से ही ये स्फूर्ति होगी। सनातन गोस्वामी हिमसेल्फ ही टेल टू दिस थिंग हाउ दिस थिंग इंस्पायर टू माई हार्ट, सनातन गोस्वामी मुझे तो हमारे बताने में तब दिस कमेंट्री राइटिंग हाउ इट इंस्पायर टू माई हार्ट बल ओनली दिस मर्सी ऑफ श्री महाप्रभु यू नो ओनली दिस थिंग इंस्पायर टू माई हार्ट।
दीज आर व्हाट ही सेइंग इज दीज आर द पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ परीक्षित महाराज उत्तरा बट हाउ वाज इट इंस्पायर सनातन गोस्वामी पास हार्ट नाउ इट वाज इंस्पायर्ड बाय महाप्रभु।
It was never written down
before. It wasn't written down. No. It was,
huh? It wasn't written down, but yeah. only 500 years ago, he got this inspiration to write this. It was there, but it wasn't written down.
Past times were performed then. Yes, the past times performed then, but it wasn't written, not in written form. It was inspired in the heart of Sanatana Goswami Pad by the inspiration of Mahaprabhu.
It's a special mercy.
Yes, that was special mercy. So, Sputti, he's used this word Sputti. Sputti means
manifestation
means Sputti, you know,
vision.
It is very difficult to translate this word Sputti. Sputti means it comes to you as a pictorial realization, let's say. Pictorial realization. You can actually see that aspect. That is what means Sputti, huh? Sorry?
It's real.
Yeah, it's real. Means they are like in the
Sanatana Goswami himself tells this thing. Sanatana Goswami himself he tells this how my heart tells this only mercy of Mahaprabhu tells this thing. यहाँ पर कहते श्री पुत्रा जैसे जैसे कथा जब सुखदेव गोस्वामी ने कथा समाप्त कर दी, अभी जब खत्म हो गई उनकी माँ उत्तरा पास में बैठी हुई थी, जब बैठी हुई थी इतने में उत्तरा प्रश्न करती है, बोले बेटा ये सुखदेव गोस्वामी सात दिन तक कथा सुना है, मैं स्त्री जाती मेरे तो पहले में कुछ पढ़ाई नहीं, स्त्री जाती है इसलिए मेरे लायक तुम कुछ बात बता, जैसे कम समय पर अंदर में मैं जैसे कुछ समझ पाऊँ। कहते अभी यहाँ पर प्रश्न करते हैं, श्री परीक्षित महाराज सोच रहे थे अभी मेरे पास बहुत कम समय है, बहुत कम समय, अभी वो तक्षक आने वाले मेरे काटने के लिए, अभी मेरे पास समय नहीं, मैं वो सोच रहे थे मैं जो कुछ सुखदेव गोस्वामी से सुना वो कोशिश करें उसको इस तरह स्मरण करें जो करता, लेकिन इतने में माँ ने प्रश्न कर, जब माँ ने प्रश्न की और माँ कितने प्यारी होती है, एक ही बेटा दुखी मेरे बेटा चले जाएगा, लेकिन इसलिए माँ की स्नेह में आकर के उन्होंने फिर तो थोड़ी समय में ही उन्होंने श्रीमद भागवत जो बृहद भागवत कथा को उन्होंने थोड़ी समय में ही उनका सार उन्होंने सुनाया।
So after the Harikatha has been spoken by Shukadeva Goswami, the entire Srimad Bhagavatam has spoken for 7 days and 7 nights. Now it is time for, Parikshit Maharaj knows, and now it is time for, his very short time is left, and Takshat the serpent will come and will bite him and he will have to leave body. So thinking like this, he is thinking that I will, whatever time is left for me, I will try to absorb myself in all the teachings, all that I have heard from Shukadeva Goswami, I will try to absorb myself in that way. When he's thinking like this, at that very moment, Uttara is saying that although she was also in that hearing of this Harikatha, but she is saying that being a woman, my mind could not absorb, my mind could not grasp all that was said in 7 days. So, oh my son, can you please tell me at least the essence of whatever he was spoken for 7 days and 7 nights? Although Shukadeva, although Parikshit Maharaj had this desire that he would absorb himself in meditating on the pastime that he had just heard, but out of his affection for his mother, he had affection for his mother, because of this affection, he decided that he will speak whatever he had heard for 7 days and 7 nights in the synopsis form, in the form of an essence, he will speak, and this is what came to be known as Brihad Bhagavatam.
यहाँ प्रश्न करते हैं तो माता ने प्रश्न की भागवत का सार सुना, यहाँ पर प्रश्न कर रहे हैं कहते अगर भागवत का अगर हम सार सुनाएंगे, भागवत का सार तो ब्रज भक्ति, और ब्रज भक्ति में भी स्तास्यल सख्य वात्सल और मधुर कहते मधुर रस में भी राधा की जो भक्ति ये सर्वश्रेष्ठ है, राधा का जो प्रेम ये सर्वश्रेष्ठ है। तब श्री सुखदेव परीक्षित महाराज ने कहा माँ क्या कहते हैं हम ब्रज की भक्ति कथा सुना है, राधा रानी के प्रेम की बात बोले नहीं, मेरे को डायरेक्ट राधा रानी के प्रेम की बात मत सुनाने करो। उदाहरण देते जैसे गन्ने का जूस निकालते, पर जूस से गुड़ बनता है, गुड़ से चीनी बनती है, चीनी से मिश्री बनती है, मिश्री से खंडसार बनता है, खंडसार कहते उसी तरह मेरे को स्टेप बाई स्टेप कथा सुना क्यों एक भक्ति से दूसरी भक्ति श्रेष्ठ, दूसरी से तीसरी, तीसरी से चौथी, अभी ब्रज भक्ति सर्वश्रेष्ठ क्यों है और राधा रानी की भक्ति सर्वश्रेष्ठ क्यों है, उसका स्टेप बाय स्टेप मत सुना, डायरेक्ट मत सुना।
So when he was asked this question, then Sanatana Goswami Prabhupada, Parikshit Maharaj is asking this question to his mother Uttara that the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam is the Braj Bhakti. And the essence of Braj Bhakti is, of course, we know that there are different relations, different pastimes to be taught in Sakya, Vatsalya, and Madhurya. And the essence of all this is Madhurya Rasa. And the essence of Madhurya Rasa is the bhakti of Radharani towards Krishna. So, Parikshit Maharaj is asking, oh mother, you are asking me the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. So, shall I tell you directly about the sweet pastimes of Radharani, the Braj Bhakti, shall I explain to you that? Then his mother Uttara says that no, although this is the essence of the Srimad Bhagavatam, but I want to don't tell me the, directly the sweetness, the pastimes of Srimati Radharani and Krishna. I want to know the gradual progress, that how one bhakti is superior to the other, how the other bhakti is superior to the previous one. I want to hear step by step to reach to the topmost bhakti of Radharani towards Krishna. He's saying just like sugar cane juice. Sugar cane is crushed, then the crusher and it gives sugar cane juice. And from the sugar cane juice, you get sugar juice and then you boil it. Then you get gur, then you get jaggery, then you get, from this you get sugar, from sugar you get mishri, and from mishri you get khandasar.
It's a sweet.
It's a sweet, means no equivalent in English. So this is khandasar, you get like this. One is means more refined than the other. The essence of this, that one is more refined than the other. So how the topmost bhakti Srimati Radhagarani, but I won't hear about this, but in the gradual progression of the bhakti.
Is she just doing that out of mercy to bring him Maharaj to fix his mind before leaving his body? Like that's it? Just
kya maa utra unse ye sawal sab aise pooch kyun pooch rahi hai, kya wo apne putra ki taraf ko dayalu hai ki unka man na hari katha mein lag jaye, ya apne liye pooch rahi hai?
ये जो लीला है ना, जैसे भगवत गीता है तो दूसरे दूसरे जो ग्रंथ है ना, उनको माँ भी को साधारण नहीं है, परिचित महाराज माँ भी को भी कोई साधारण नहीं है। अगर ये प्रश्न नहीं करते तो हम कहाँ से सुनता रहेगा? अगर अर्जुन अगर प्रश्न नहीं करता, अर्जुन का मोह अगर नहीं होता ये गीता कर कहाँ से आता? अगर मोह अगर सिर्फ व्यास देव का नहीं होता तो ये भागवत ग्रंथ कहाँ से आता? इसलिए कहीं ना कहीं लोगों ने कुछ ना कुछ चीज़ को निमित्त बना करके जो ग्रंथों को दुनिया में हम जैसे बद्धे जीवों को ऊपर में कृपा करना चाहते हैं, किसी तरह का नहीं होता हम ग्रंथ का आदि सुनते।
So this is actually what is Mother Uttara is asking Parikshit Maharaj. Actually, this is for the mercy of conditioned souls like us, because all these scriptures that you hear today, Bhagavad Gita, what is it? The Arjun, he is bewildered, and because he is bewildered, he is asking so many questions. Krishna answers. Now it is eternally present in the form of Bhagavad Gita as a lesson to us. And other scriptures also question that Srimad Bhagavatam,
like this Vyas Devi also bewildered. How possible Vyas Devi to bewildered? And how this is the, like this scripture, Uttara, who is the Uttara? Who is the take darshan of direct Krishna? And Krishna, Krishna entered the form of Uttara, no? Uttara's form, Krishna also, he also entered this womb and he takes the son. So they are Vishwanath Chakravarti, you know, like this Pandavas, they are going to Banavas, you know, they are going to Paresh. So Vishwanath Chakravarti, he gave commentary, but this is the where can be so many disturb in this life, where you have anarthas. Anarthas. But this anarthas, sraddha, sadhu sangha, bhajana kriya, and anartha nibriti. He is the first stage in the anartha nibriti. You know? The Pandavas, they are eternal associates of Lord Krishna. Then it becomes ruchi, then nishtha, then second bhav, then the prey. But this Pandavas, who is there? They are premi bhakta, you know, they are not ordinary bhakta. They are the jnani, bhakta, sudha, prema, par bhakta there. No, they are prema, par bhakta. So Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is telling how possible with the prema, par bhakta, when only anarthas move, meaning all kind of, when only nama bhas, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur telling, when only not pure name, when you have nama bhas, that time there are all kind of suffering move. Coat, beach, you know, this all kind of suffering finishing where you are only nama bhas. But Pandavas, with the Pandavas, their eternal association, how possible they are, you know, 13 years they are going to forest, you know, moving whole world. But no, this is the Krishna's desire. Krishna's desire, why? He know when Pandavas going somewhere, when this food touch, then this all whole world become pure guy, you know. So, you know, so this Pandavas going to perish and perish. Like this thing also, you know, they are eternal associates, they are Krishna's. You know, if they are not being questioned, how possible today we are listening this past time. And okay, Mimika Ranagrik is Karasi Amara Pai Chodhi Gai.
She was just an idiot to leave all these beautiful pastimes for us.
She liberated soul.
She is a liberated soul, like our mother. So she has associated with Krishna. She has had Krishna enter her room. How can she be liberated?
He took darshan of Krishna, and he saw with Parikshit Maharaj. They are not ordinary person. Isliye Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami kehte hain, Chaitanya Charitamrita mein kati ye brihat Bhagavata Amrita Sambandh mein Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Chaitanya Charitamrita ko ulekh karte hain. कभी बृहद भागवत अमृत ग्रंथ है क्या चीज, कभी जिस ग्रंथ को पढ़ने पर आपको तीन चीज स्पष्ट रूप में पता चल जाएगा, बोले क्या है, कभी एक कृष्ण कौन है, दूसरी है भक्त कौन है, जो पांच वर्ग का भक्त और भक्ति क्या चीज है, कभी ये तीन चीज आपको आसानी से ये बृहद भागवत अमृत ग्रंथ पढ़ने से आपको ये तीन तत्व आपको अंदर के तीन तत्व आ जाएंगे.
Krishna Goswami Prabhupada, Krishna Goswami Jnana, he has described in Chaitanya Charitamrita, he has mentioned this Bhaira Bhagavatamrita, and there he said that by reading Bhaira Bhagavatamrita, actually you can get three results. He said you will understand what is a devotee, but because there are descriptions of five types of devotees, and then who is Krishna, and then what is bhakti. He will describe that different types of bhakti, different types of sadhana and all. So you will, when you read this Bhaira Bhagavatamrita, immediately you will very clear, you will have a clear understanding of all these three. One is Krishna, Bhakta and Bhakti. Krishna, Bhakta, Bhakti.
इसलिए कहते जो बृहद भागवत अमृत ग्रंथ है, कहते ये दो भाग में विभक्त है, एक पूर्व खंड और एक उत्तर खंड. ये दो खंड रूप में ये विभाजन हुआ है. कहते एक खंड में तो जो भक्त इतने तरह का ज्ञानी शुद्ध प्रेम ये भक्त और लास्ट में जो भक्ति भक्त कितने तरह के हैं. और दूसरे खंड में जो गुरुदेव से जो हम लोग ने मंत्र प्राप्त किया है, ये मंत्र कोई साधारण वस्तु नहीं है. ये चीज हम समझना चाह रहे हैं, जैसे गोप कुमार के जीवन चरित्र उसमें आती है, वो कैसे वो मंत्र जप करके रहा, वो मंत्र कभी छोड़ा नहीं, वो मंत्र को हर समय मिले तो बस गुरु मंत्र जप करके रहा. और मंत्र भी जीव का एक नित्य सिद्ध स्वभाव है, नित्य सिद्ध स्वभाव से प्राकृतम हृदय साधकता नित्य सिद्ध भाव प्रकट होता है. इसलिए उसके अंदर में जो एक नित्य सिद्ध भाव है क्या है, सो गोलोक धाम है. गोलोक धाम में कृष्ण का सखा है. इसलिए वो एक दिन वो मंत्र धीरे 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 और मंत्र शक्ति उसको धीरे 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 गोलोक प्राप्त करा देगी. इसलिए दूसरे खंड में एक मंत्र की महत्व और दूसरी है जितने भी धाम अलग अलग भूर भूव मोह जन तप सत्य उसके बाद वैकुंठ द्वार फिर अयोध्या मत द्वारका मथुरा गोलोक वृंदावन सर्वश्रेष्ठ धाम में गोलोक वृंदावन धाम सर्वश्रेष्ठ है. कहते ये जो तत्व है कहते ये दो खंड में ये तत्व एकदम स्पष्ट रूप में निरूपण करता है जी का लक्ष्य क्या है सर्वश्रद्धा क्या और गुरु मंत्र है क्या चीज ये चीज वो स्थापन करते हैं.
So there are two parts to this Brihadbhagavatamrita. It is described as Purkhand and Uttarkhand. Purkhand means the eastern and the northern part. So it is described that in this Brihadbhagavatamrita, there is descriptions, of course, of the Jnani Bhakt, Jnani Bhakt, Premakar Bhakt, Premakar Bhakt, like this. There are descriptions of the different grades of devotees. And also there is description of the topmost of the abode that one reaches. The topmost abode is described that how it is description of Bhubhuva, Swara till Vaikuntha, and then from Vaikuntha to Ayodhya, Mathura, and Golok Vrindavan, the description of all these abodes, and how Golok Vrindavan is the topmost abode, it is described in this. And then also in the second part, these teachings are given, in the second part, the teaching is given, the effect or the strength of the mantra that your Gurudev gives. This is by the pastime of Gopal Kumar described that how he goes and travels all over the universe, but the mantra that has been given to him, his eternally perfect relation with the Lord is to be a Nitya Sakha in Golokana. So this is his end, because when he is chanting this, he comes to the realization of this, that this is his eternal form, and how he keeps on going from one planetary system to the other, but he never leaves the chanting of this mantra. So it is, and by the description of this pastime to the second part of the Brihadbhagavatamrita, it is description that how the, what is the effect of the mantra, that how this mantra that you attend from the from your Gurudev, it is not ordinary, and what effect it can have on your life, on your spiritual life, when you chant this sincerely and without breaking of this chanting.
So, you can be very careful, you know. So, Gurudev, Guruji mantra he gave to us, necessary, you know, here is after Gopal Kumar, he tried to chant this name, you know, and tried to chant this mantra. And this power of this mantra, he take to everywhere, you know. This mantra he take to everywhere to him. And if he is not satisfied, you know, he continually try chant this mantra. You know, continue. That meaning Gurudev, whose mantra he gave to us, necessary you are must chant. They are telling, Sabhaisama, they are telling, if you 3 days don't chant this Guru mantra, telling this power of this mantra, you will finish it. If continue, you don't chant it 3 times again, even listening to this mantra to Gurudev. You know? So scripture telling. So necessary, you are Gurudev heart, you give to mantra every day, 3 times, even try chant this mantra. Never, you know, never forget this mantra. So there is sign this mantra and the power of this mantra. And when chanting this mantra before you can take achman, you know, Ganesha Jamnesha Gudavari Saraswati Narmada Sindhu Gavari Jalasmin Sandhi Guru, you know, to do achman and establish Tilak and try to chanting this Guru mantra. So necessary continue, you can chant this mantra never. Let any time this chant this mantra. So when you know there are so many teachings of this mantra. कर यहाँ पर कह रहे प्रश्न है कभी ये श्री सनातन गोस्वामी कहते हैं ये ग्रंथ कौन सुन सकता है. वो कहते हैं सभी ये ग्रंथ नहीं सुन सकते हैं. इसलिए उसमें चार चीज उन्होंने बताई. चार चीज में कहते अधिकारी कौन के ग्रंथ सुनने का अधिकारी, दूसरा है अभिनय, तीसरा है संबंध और चौथा है प्रयोजन. ये चार चीज ग्रंथ में बताते हैं. इसलिए कहते हैं ग्रंथ सुनने का अधिकारी कौन है. बोले सब के ग्रंथ सुनने का अधिकारी नहीं, सबके लिए मना किया. बोले कौन सुन सकता है, कोई सुन सकते हैं जिनकी लक्ष्य है राधा रमण की चरण की मकरंद को जो पान करना चाहते, केवल वही कथा समी ग्रंथ को पढ़ सकते. क्यों, ये ग्रंथ में लास्ट तक उन्होंने ब्रज भक्ति तक उन्होंने पहुंचा है, ब्रज भक्ति तक पहुंचा है. मतलब ये कथा को कौन सुन सकता है, जिनकी उद्देश्य ब्रज भक्ति और आधारण की प्रेम प्राप्त करना, वही ये ग्रंथ को केवल वही अधिकार सुनने.
So, there are further, he's describing that there are four descriptions, four topics of grand description in this scripture. that first is adhikari, that who is adhikari, who is qualified to receive a scripture. And then there is abhidhaya, sambandha, and prayodaya. These abhidhaya descriptions are the proper discussion in this scripture. It's saying that who is qualified, who is adhikari, who is qualified to listen to this scripture. It is said not everybody can hear this scripture. Only those who are having their heart desire to get in the service of Radha Raman's to bring the nectar, the makaran of Radha Raman's lotus feet, only they are qualified to hear this Srimad Bhagavatam. Why? Because what is the description in this pastime, in this Srimad Bhagavatam? It is the description of Guru Bhagavatam, description of the relationship with the Lord Shri Krishna in Gaurabhama. So anybody who has this desire that they want to taste the nectar of Radha Rama's lotus feet, they are qualified. And then hear the scripture, and then of course there are descriptions of Abhidhaya, Sambandha, and Abhidhaya.
Abhidhaya
means sadhana.
बोले जिनके कॉपी प्रेम प्राप्ति की इच्छा है कभी यही इसमें साधन बताया कभी क्योंकि उनके साधन करोगे तो तब तो प्रेम को पाओगे ना फिर कहते संबंध क्या है कहते इनके लीला कथा है कहते प्रयोजन क्या है कहते प्रयोजन है उनकी प्रेम सेवा है उनका प्रयोजन है
So it's describing that Abhidhaya means what practice we have performed, the practice that we have performed, he's describing that Just like the moves of the gopis, we perform our sadhana. That is the sadhana. And then
Samandha, Krishna, Lila,
to hear the pastimes of Krishna, his devotees, to hear these pastimes, this is our samandha. And
prayojan, of course,
to get the service of the prem seva of the divine power of Radha Raman, this is our
prayojan.